In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of the muscle of piriformis. This beige tape represents the piriformis. I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, the movement, and important relationship with sciatic nerve. So the origin of piriformis is kind of tricky. When you open up anatomy book, the picture looks like piriformis attaches on the lateral side of the sacrum. It's technically not correct. Actually, piriformis originates anterior part of the sacrum. If I move this bony model, you see the tape originates from the anterior part of the sacrum. You see this gap? That means piriformis originates from anterior part. Of course, in reality, you don't see this gap, but I want to show you it actually originates from anterior part of the sacrum, okay? The origin of piriformis is anterior part of the sacrum. Then its insertion is right here, this part. This part is greater trochanter. Greater trochanter is the bony prominence on the femur. Actually, it's very easy to palpate. There is not much thick muscles here, so you can palpate on your hip joint. So origin is anterior part of the sacrum. Insertion is greater trochanter. So what is the function of piriformis? The main function are two things. The one is external rotation of hip joint. External rotation. You see, as I rotate externally, this tape kind of slacks. That means in reality, this is muscle contraction. You know, when muscle contracts, that means muscle shortens, right? So in this case, if you see the slack in this tape, that means the contraction in reality. Make sense? So external rotation of the hip joint. One other function is abduction of hip joint. Abduction is when you raise up hip joint laterally or you open up leg. You see, there is a slack on this tape. That means this is contracting in reality. Two functions, external rotation and abduction. This is very, very important. You know, this is not the function of piriformis, but since piriformis originates from anterior part of the sacrum, it's very important for lower back pain. Imagine if this part is fixed, then if piriformis contracts, the muscle pulls sacrum this way, not this much, but this can create stress on the sacrum. Then sacrum has articulation with the pelvis and lumbar spines up. So this lack of balance can create lower back pain. Of course, piriformis is not the only cause for back pain, but this can be one cause for lower back pain. So in next part, I'd like to explain the relationship with sciatic nerve. Very important nerve. So piriformis and sciatic nerve. Remember, this beige tape is piriformis. Remember, it originates from anterior part of the sacrum and is inserted on the greater trochanter. And you see this yellow wire? This represents sciatic nerve. Sciatic nerve originates from sacrum. It's from anterior part of the sacrum and it comes like this and shows up from inferior part of the piriformis. And sciatic nerve goes all the way down to the foot, okay? So sciatic nerve innervates like hamstrings and calf and the plantar muscles. It changes name like tibial nerve, but you know, they are from sciatic nerve. So sciatic nerve has relationship with piriformis. So what happens if piriformis gets tight or it gets shortened? It can pinch sciatic nerve. So if sciatic nerve got impingement, it can have a pain on the backside of the thigh or numbness on posterior part of the thigh. So the piriformis is very important for hip movement, and I just explained it's important for lower back pain, and it's important for pain around the thigh, maybe knee or calf area. So piriformis and sciatic nerve. Actually, there's few more nerves are involved with piriformis, but in this video, I just wanted to explain you a relationship with sciatic nerve and piriformis. So in this video, I explained the anatomy of piriformis, its origin and insertion, the movement, remember it's external rotation, and abduction. At last, I explained relationship with sciatic nerve and piriformis. So I hope this video helps you, and if you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.